I'm going to grab the quick selection tool, or you can press W on the keyboard. When you do this, you'll see up here this command called select subject. So let's press it, and after a couple of seconds, the selection appears on the screen. It did a good job on the lower side, but I still have to manually select the umbrella. So I'm just going to zoom in right here holding Z on the keyboard, select the polygonal lasso tool, hold shift, because this way we can add to the existing selection by creating points around the umbrella, and then close the selection. Same thing on the right side, holding down shift and adding to the existing selection until I completely cover the umbrella. I'm also double checking these details of the umbrella and refine my selection accordingly. I like to take care of small details when doing my selections. Now, I can click on Select and Mask and refine my selection by adding a bit of smoothness and 30% of contrast. I select the output to new layer with layer mask and then hit OK. Good, now let's see what I did here. I have two layers. One of them will be the background and the other one that stays on top. It's the same layer but with a layer mask on it that shows only the woman and the umbrella. You can even rename these layers as you want in order to help you, because we will have a bunch of layers in the end, so it helps you to be more organized. Next step, create a solid color adjustment layer, make it black, and drag the layer to the bottom of the list. Select the background layer, apply a mask to it by clicking here, press G to choose the gradient tool, make sure you press D to reset the foreground and background colors in this area, and then from the horizon line, drag down the gradient until the bottom of the image. The main thing here is to hide the horizon line, because on the black part of the mask, I will insert another image. Before going forward, I need to take care of some details on the umbrella. You see, there are some spots that I want to remove, and also, because the umbrella has some transparency in it, I can see the horizon line in this area. So if I fix these, this will look like a white or bright gray umbrella, which is great. I will hide this layer, and to clean up the parts on the umbrella, I will use the healing brush tool. I'm sampling from different areas, holding down Alt, and then brushing over the parts that I want to change. Until I finish this, I just want to say that if you want to see more tutorial type videos just like this one, consider subscribing and press the like under this video. That will be appreciated. So I'm done taking care of these parts on the umbrella, and now let's take this tutorial to the next step, which is adding the next photo for this compositing project. I'm just placing this image inside the document, and I will scale it up just a bit until I get rid of the bottom part, which is not needed. Press Enter, and I have this beautiful night shot of the stars and the Milky Way. I drag this layer between the color fill layer and the background, just like this. Now you can see the effect of this layer mask. The black area reveals the layer underneath, which is the second image that I inserted. By the way, let's rename this layer to Sky. Next step, I need to turn this bottom part of the background layer to a more bluish color to make it blend in better with the color of the night sky. For this, one of the easiest way is to add a solid color adjustment layer, choose a blue tone, it doesn't have to be perfect at this point, hit OK, and now put this layer on soft light blending mode and clip it to the background layer by holding Alt and pressing between these two layers. This means that the solid color layer will only affect the layer underneath it, which is the background layer. Otherwise, if the layer is not clipped, it will affect all the layers below this one. So I'm going to clip it back. Now I can tweak the color even more by double-clicking the solid color layer and choosing a more precise color with the eyedropper. A color that already exists in the night sky photo, or you can go even with a lighter color if you want. You should take your time with this until you obtain a good result. What I want now is to blur the background just a bit. I feel that the night sky image has some noise and I would like to separate the subject better from the background. As you can see, the night sky layer is a smart object, so I can add smart filters to it and modify them anytime. So, filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Let's check out how it looks with a 2 value or even a 3. Hit OK and it looks much better now. Let's blend the subject as well more into this composition. And for this, I'm going to add another solid color adjustment layer. I'm trying to choose a similar color to the blue tone that I have in my image. Put this layer on soft light, clip it to this layer holding Alt, and then tweak the color even more by double-clicking on the solid color layer. And when I'm done, I hit OK. Now, because we changed the background from a very bright one to a dark night sky, I need to lower the brightness of the layer that contains the woman and the umbrella, because now it looks fake. So I'm going to add a curves adjustment layer. I'm going to clip it to the layer below this one. To darken the bright areas, I grab this point and bring it down until I feel that the whole image looks much better. I will create another point in the shadows area and bring it down as well. And you can see a before and after if I enable or disable this curves layer. It makes a big difference. Now, I want to duplicate the layer with the sky because I would like to have some bigger bright spots in the image in the foreground to simulate somehow that it's raining outside and this is the reason why the woman is holding this umbrella. So I select the layer with the night sky, I press Ctrl plus J to duplicate the layer, right-click in this area where the smart filters are, and choose Clear Smart Filters. Also, right-click on the layer and choose Rasterize Layer. Then, place it at the top of the list. The thing is that I only need a small part of this night sky. I want to simulate some rain. With the Rectangular Marquee tool, I select an area, choose the Move tool, and then scale this part until it covers the whole document. I will rename this layer to Rain, put this layer on screen blending mode, and then add a curves layer which should be clipped to the rain layer. I want to darken this and create more contrast in it. It's time to add some motion blur to create a more realistic rain. So I go to Filter, Blur, Motion Blur, and for me, a minus 56 degree and a distance of 20 pixels will be just fine. I tweaked these settings before recording this tutorial. So I'm going to hit OK, and now I can add a layer mask here, and using a low flow of 13%, I take the brush and paint with black on the woman's face, just to keep it more visible in the composition. You can always press X to switch between black and white to hide or unhide parts on a layer mask, but keep in mind that you always need to select the layer mask first. Okay, the next steps will include some lighting tweaks that will make this image look much better than now, in my opinion. So the first thing that I want to do is to add a curves layer, brighten it up, and then invert the layer mask by pressing Ctrl plus I. The layer mask just became black. Now I take the brush, make sure I paint with white, I check the flow to be around 40%, and then with a big brush, I just press multiple times in this area until I see that the background is brightening up. Now, I select the curves layer which is clipped to the subject. Add another curves layer, raise the midtones to brighten up the image, select the layer mask, invert it with Ctrl plus I, and now it becomes black, so the effect is not visible. Take a white brush and dab a few times on her face and around the head until that area is more bright than before. You can then check the before and after if you disable the curves layer and you can see the difference. And there is more to do here, but first let me create some groups in the layer list because things got more complex here and I want to organize these much better. So let's create a group for the background, then select all these layers and press Ctrl plus G to make a group for the subject. And now everything looks organized. Okay, now pay attention. I will press Shift plus Ctrl plus Alt plus E to create a new stamp visible layer. This layer contains all the existing layers, but in one single image. So now I can right click, convert it to a smart object, and then go to one of my favorite panels in Photoshop, in Filter, the Camera Raw Filter. Here I can increase the contrast to 40. I can do the same for the shadows to reveal some more details there. So let's keep it at 60. And also, I will increase the clarity to 30. Hit OK, and you can always go back to the Camera Raw filter if you want by double-clicking here and changing any setting that you want. Very nice before and after for this blue fantasy look, and I hope you like it too. Check out another video from the screen if you have the time, and if you have any questions, just leave them in the comments, and I will try my best to reply. Bye-bye now.